Intro, take three.
Hello, we're Group 9, and today we're going to be talking about curves and surfaces.
Easy.
It's about kids.
So why are we interested in curves and surfaces? What's so important about this topic? Well, it's got many applications outside of mathematics and in. For example, physics. And engineering. And as I said before, even in mathematics. For example, when proving Fermat's last theorem.
Okay, so let's start off with the basics. What is a curve? So a curve is a physical representation of how a point moves with time. We're going to be looking at two types of curves. So they are plane curves and space curves. But what exactly are they? So a plane curve shows us how a point moves in two-dimensional space, R2. It tells us how a point moves up and down as well as side to side with respect to time.
A space curve is similar but also shows how the point moves backwards and forwards in space. So in other words, it shows us how the point moves in three dimensions. From the equation of a plane curve, we can gather a lot of different information about its properties. Today we are going to be looking at the plane curve gamma. The first thing we can check is if our curve is regular. What we mean by that is the derivative of the curve ever equals zero for any value of t. In this case, gamma prime, or the derivative, is never equal to zero, as it contains constants that are greater than zero. Hence, we can say that this curve is regular.
Knowing that this curve is regular, we can try to reparameterize by unit speed. What we mean by this is there is another way to write this curve such that none of its properties change except that the norm of the derivative is now equal to 1. In order to reparameterize a curve, there are 5 steps to follow. Step 1, is gamma regular? Step 2, compute the arc length function s of t. Step 3, compute the inverse function phi of t of the arc length function. Step 4, create a composite function called gamma tilde. Step 5, check that gamma tilde has unit speed.
In the case of our curve, computing the arc length function is a long and tedious process that is not possible by hand since an elliptic integral comes into play, and so we cannot reparameterize our plane curve. Moving on, we can compute the curvature and the signed curvature of gamma. What we're doing here is looking at some of the properties of the shape of the curve. The curvature gives a numerical value to exactly how much the curve curves. There are two equations that we can use to calculate the curvature, and which one we use depends on if the curve is unit speed or not.
So, if the curve is unit speed, then what does this mean about our curvature? Well, our curvature can be given by kappa. However, if the curve isn't unit speed, but it is still regular, then kappa is worked out by the following formula. We come across special cases regarding the curvature for certain curves. For example, when we look at a regular plane curve, the curvature can also be calculated by the following. Using this formula, we can see that the curvature for our gamma is this.
Now that we've looked at the curvature for our curve, we can now look at the signed curvature. The signed curvature tells us in which direction the curve curves in relation to the normal. The formula for the sine curvature is very much the same as the curvature for a curve. For our curve gamma, the sine curvature is... Using all the information we have gathered about our plane curve, we can now begin to visualise and see what our plane curve looks like.
Having looked at plane curves, we can now move on to space curves. A space curve is in 3 dimensions. Again, from the equation of gamma, we can look at many of the different properties that the curve has. The curve gamma is again a regular curve. The process to check if a space curve is regular is identical to checking if a plane curve is regular. And again, we are unable to reparameterize our space curve for the same reason as our plane curve.
Moving on, we could look at the curvature of a space curve. In this case, we can use the formula for calculating the curvature for 3 dimensions. We know that the curvature tells us how much the curve curves, but the torsion tells us how much a space curve deviates from lying in a plane. The torsion of the curve can be calculated like so. where B is the binormal of gamma and N is the normal.
Using the curvature and the torsion of the space curve, we can see that our curve looks like... Having looked at the curves, we can move on to more advanced material. A surface is geometrically described as a bent piece of paper. Our formula for our map is... There are many different types of surfaces. We can test to see if X is a surface patch. A surface patch S is said to be one when X is smooth and if the partial derivatives XU and XV are linearly independent.
Our function X is smooth since it's differentiable at all U, V elements of the real numbers. To check the partial derivatives are linearly independent, we need to show that the norm of the cross product of the two partial derivatives is zero. Since our surface is a surface patch, we can find the first and second fundamental forms. The first fundamental form is the inner product of the tangent vector. Its coefficients can be used to calculate the arc length of a curve on the surface. The coefficients of the first fundamental form are the second fundamental form measures how the curves curve away from the surface.
The coefficients of the second fundamental form are... From here, we can calculate the Gaussian and mean curvatures for our surface. The Gaussian curvature is a product of the eigenvalues from our shape operator, but can also be calculated using the coefficients of our fundamental forms seen below.
The mean curvature is the average of the minimal or maximal curvatures and is the average of our principal curvatures, but can also be calculated from the coefficients of our fundamental forms.
The normal and geodesic curvatures show very specific properties of the curve. The geodesic curvature shows how an object in equilibrium that is being projected at the surface ricochets off.
The geodesic curvature can also be calculated like this.
The normal curvature at a point is the amount of the curve's curvature in the direction of the surface normal. For our surface, the normal curvature can also be calculated using the coefficients of the fundamental forms.
Compiling all our information, we can see that our surface looks like this.
As we have seen from the analysis of our curves and surface, the plane curve, space curve and surface are all related to one another. To put it informally, if you take a vertical dissection of our surface, we can obtain our plane curve. Our space curve is what can be used to generate our surface. Hopefully this video has been insightful, engaging and beneficial. Thank you from Group 9.